You could say that the event of global warming illustrated the principle of cutting carbon emissions, which in turn has guided a whole raft of environmental actions. For our next story, we start a new series of features on the new market in green services. You may have heard of blue and white collar jobs, but what about a green collar job? In the first of the series, we meet a specialist who helps companies save electricity. Because the office is situated here, so somewhere around here we'll take our lux measurement. 817. It's a bit high and should be lower.
In only 2 or 3 seconds, this digital lux meter can accurately record how much light the ceiling light is putting out, which is higher than normal. Measurements are taken from throughout the office because lighting needs vary in different environments.
In a work environment such as this, typical illuminance ranges from 500 to 700. An area like a restroom can be even lower. In dealing with office buildings, we spend most of our energies on communication. We tell people the real benefits of conservation and help the owners' association reach a consensus. Most of the time, it's just a matter of taking on a different perspective. So in the summer, you turn on two big units and three smaller units, right? So the 300 ton and 200 units are on, and the 800 ton units are also running. Right now, I'm gathering some basic information through a questionnaire. We first want to understand their AC deployment, the unit's capacity, and if it's enough. We also want to know their settings and usage for every season.
Just like a doctor, the conservation specialist diagnoses problems and prescribes remedies tailored to the energy needs of this office building.
Diagnosis includes a few economic analyses to let customers know when their initial investment will break even. So we print up a lot of reports and tell them the most important things to address. It's service-oriented. Our clients don't know their current energy usage and how to maximize it. The key is people's skills. We provide a service by teaching our clients.
Far East Century Plaza in Taipei County's Zhonghe City is home to 450 businesses, making it one of the largest office complexes in Taiwan. The complex is troubled by an ever-rising electricity bill. The maintenance team of its owners' association was unable to solve the problem until this conservation specialist came along.
The biggest energy cost here is the water cooler. It took up to 60% of electricity used. Sometimes the difference of a degree in temperature meant a 3% change to the electricity bill. 3 degrees means 10%.
The air conditioning racks up about $700,000 on our electricity bill. His solution can save us about $70,000, which is about cutting 10% of our electricity usage.
All it took was installing inverters on these older units to regulate their thermal power flow according to the seasons. $70,000 was saved in the first year. The next year will be a total of $140,000. Economic benefits and conservation awareness converged in a practical fashion, all thanks to the conservation specialist.
全球暖化，大家都要重视，各种各样的节能减碳。 希望能够带动绿色产业应运而生，所以呢，从今天开始，大家新闻特别锁定这个主题来看看，现在在产业界所带动一个新趋势。先来看看台湾的立法脚步，经济部呢是在 99年1月19号修正通过了能源管理法，针对呢一些的节约能源的使用管理措施，从7月1号开始生效。那么就是包括了各种各样的百货公司啦、超商、超市、量贩店，还有呢连锁店等等，必须要做到两件事情。第一个， 冷气是不能够外泄的。另外呢，也开始禁用白炽灯泡，这就是要节约能源。如果违规的话，要罚款2万到10万元不等。那么在这种立法同时整个环境趋势的情况之下，我们要为您介绍的是现在的所谓最夯的绿能产业。过去都听到有蓝领阶级和我的白领阶级，现在呢最红的不是科技新贵，而是绿领新贵。因为呢他们能够为节能减碳重新做规划，也开放出所谓的蓝海新职场。那这一群的节能工程师呢，多半是要结合了电子、物理、冷冻技术等等的专业工程技术，然后转型之后成了现在职场上的最受瞩目的新贵。他们工作到底是怎么进行的呢？今天我们就先从住商大楼如何节能减碳，来看看这群的节能规划师如何运作。
因为办公在这个地方，所以我们大概就放在这个地方来检测它的照度。
817号，这个跳动，这个其实可以再降一点点，这么关系。
只要2-3秒，照度测量仪就能精确告知这上头的灯的确有点耗电。在办公室里随处做记录，节能规划师得这样熟门熟路。就因为光是灯光照度，在不同的空间场合里都有它不同的基本值。
这个区域其实大概这样的一个照度范围，500到700就够了。那像换洗室其实不用那么亮。其实我们在像住办大楼这边，其实最大的花最多 effort 的，其实就是在沟通部分。我们告诉他，这节能的实际上的真正的好处，让促成这管委会能够达成更多的共识。其实这很多都是一个观念的转换的问题。
那个我应该这样讲，这个人是谁啊？刚才介绍，
夏到夏天的时候，
夏天的部分。
是
两大三小
就是
就等于是三百吨一台跟200吨一台都开，
就800吨有开就对了。其实它是一个类似一个访谈的一个问卷呐，我们先了解说跟客户这边先了解说，你这个先了解一下说它的这个目前的主机的那个配置情形，它的吨位、它的吨数够不够啊？然后我们看到它整个在夏天跟冬天或者春秋之际，它目前它的那个。它的调配情形，
找出耗能的可能病灶，节能规划师透过会诊，就像医师一样，还得对症下药，开立常办大楼的专属诊单。
那是处方签，有包含了一些经济效益分析，就告诉他你这样做几年就可以回收，所以我们大概就是说会列了好像很多条，但是会告诉他哪个是最重要的，那他是接近顾客的。那我怎么知道？这顾客怎么知道他要用什么样的东西？那他的节能的状态，他的使用能源的状态达到什么样的效果？那所以要靠人，关键的人去跟 customer 做互动，所以就会形成服务。
坐落在台北中和的远东世纪大楼，450家中小企业进驻，堪称是全台最大的厂办园区。但逐年攀升的高电量，屡创新高的惊人电费，让公务组伤透脑筋。即便看出了问题，却苦无解决之道，找来节能规划师才药到病除。
这里面最耗能的冰水主机最耗能。占了60%，你们看锐度的时候它三%以上的耗能，3度就10%的耗能。
目前呢，总共使用的电费呢，在空调的部分呢，差不多是2200万，它也可以节省到200多万，那已经节省了1/4的总耗电量。
只在老旧机器上装设了变频器，就能依照冬夏季节的离峰高峰做运转调整。第一年省下电费200万，隔年又再节约400万元，实质达到经济效益与节约能源的双赢局面。而这关键就在于妙手回春的节能意识。